I'm going to read this so I get through it properly and do it properly. I'm announcing today that I'm ending my campaign for re-election. This is exclusively a personal decision driven by personal circumstances. My family has been dealing for some time with a difficult challenge, a health challenge for one of our members that has recently evolved to the point where it's no longer appropriate for me to continue this campaign. My wife Betty and I have unique obligations to this part of our family, and that's where we need to devote our attention. You know, I've always tried to weigh my family's responsibility with my civic responsibilities and the desire to help Rochester's transformation, but frankly, I'm not sure I've always made the correct decisions. I think I am making the correct decision today. Now, I believe that my announcement today will and should mean that Lovely Warren will be elected as our next mayor. I intend to work to make that occur successfully, and I urge everyone to do so as well. After the election, my administration will work to assist in the transition, and I believe that these things are in the best interests of our city at this time. I'm going to be mayor till the end of the year, and I intend to use that time to continue to address the city's transformation. My announcement today obviously invites speculation about what might have happened before and after what I'm saying here. I'm not interested, quite frankly, in that speculation, and I'm not going to engage in it. What I'm interested in is moving on from here. When I came to City Hall at the request of then-Mayor Bob Duffy, the last thing I ever expected was to wind up as mayor. But I looked at the job in the same spirit that I answered Mayor Duffy's call to join in his administration, and that is to help and serve the city that I love and has been so good to me. This is not a job that you finish in any case. It will be forever a work in progress. It's no less so today. There are many important and vital decisions that have to be made now and have to be made in the future. Keeping our city solvent and making sure it continues to grow while other cities are failing around us is chief among them. As I said before, the city's been good to me and it's been good to my family. I've tried to use my skills and my experience to the benefit of all and to keep us moving in the right direction. I'll leave to others to judge whether I've done a good job as mayor. But in any case, I'm deeply grateful to the people who've worked on and contributed to my campaigns, to the senior staff here at the city, and to all the hardworking city employees who have made whatever success we've had possible, and to the citizens of this great city who have given me the privilege of being their mayor. I ask that following the general election, the city support and work hard to help our next mayor. Our city's future depends on it, and that is how we should all behave. Thank you. And I'm happy to answer, maybe not happy, but I will answer any questions you might have.
You said this was strictly for personal reasons, but you must have weighed some options here and weighed your chances in a November election.
Actually, no, Rachel, believe it or not. I knew this was a problem. You know, we've been dealing with this for a long time. So I decided I would get this resolved first, and I wouldn't engage in any speculation about what might happen and what my chances were or anything else. We never got to it. And that's the truth.
Without crying, you said a family member, can we say a family member dealing with a health issue?
Yeah, family member is dealing with a health issue. It's in the statement. You can say that, yeah.
What's next for you?
You know, I don't know. You know, if you look back on my life, it would be a mistake to try to predict what's next for me. What is next for me is clear. Two things are clear. One of them is that I'll continue to be mayor and try to do a good job till the end of the year. And second of all, I got to deal with some things in my family. You know, neither of those things will probably last forever, and we'll see what happens. I haven't really thought about it.
Did you tell Lovely of your decision today?
I haven't, although I'm scheduled to meet with her later this week. And the reason I didn't do that, I really have told almost no one, quite frankly. Is, you know, I wanted to keep it in this category. I wanted to keep this as a personal decision. I don't want to cloud it up with the politics and the things that, you know, inevitably leak into all of these decisions. And now I'll have to deal with the consequences, and I will.
This was never your decision to get into politics. You were drafted. But in that time, I mean, talk just kind of reflecting on your time as mayor. I mean, you said that some of your decisions, you think you made it the wrong one. But in the end, are you glad you were mayor?
Yes. What I meant by that statement about decisions are wrong, I meant about how I balanced my personal life and private life. That's what I meant. You know, I've had a bunch of jobs through my life, and this is not the first time I've had to deal with this. And, you know, I look back at it, I'm not necessarily proud of all the other decisions I made, but this one I am. You know, I've tried in this job to, I wanted this job, you know, I ran for it, so I don't want to be cute about it. I've worked real hard to do as good a job as I could at it. It was important to me to do a good job here, to do the right thing. But I've tried to make sure that I didn't fall into what I feel is kind of the political trap. And the political trap, as I describe it, is that you need the job. That's different than wanting it. It's different than doing it. It's that you need it. And when that happens to you, you make bum decisions, I think. You know, you make bad decisions. Now, time will tell whether I was successful at that, successful in fighting off the need for it. But I sure have tried. I sure have tried.
And then looking back, are there any accomplishments that you feel
you
would like to?
No, I think there are a lot of accomplishments here, and I'm proud of the time I've spent here. I'm proud of the people that I've worked with here. But I don't want to. You know, I don't want to deal with that here. I don't think that's necessary. You know, I mean, other people can judge that. You know, I know there's a style to these things where you're supposed to throw all these good accomplishments over your shoulder when you make the announcement, but I'll let that go for another day.
Will you officially endorse Lovely Warren and maybe help her in her campaign?
Well, what I've said is in the statement, and I think it's clear. You know, I've said that I think Lovely is going to be the next mayor and that she should be, and that I'm going to work to make that successful. Now, what role I would play in that, I don't know. You know, and that's not something we've talked about. And, you know, the reason that I'm making this decision constrains, to some extent, what I'm prepared to do. And that wouldn't just apply to me, it would apply to anybody who asked me to do something.
Okay, we're done.
I was just going to say, do you think there's anything left to do, Mayor? Sometimes they might say, you're now in a lame duck position, you really can't get anything done. Is there something that you still would like to do for the city before you...
Well, first of all, there's plenty left to do, and there will always be plenty left to do. You know, and a lot of, for instance, a lot of the projects that we're in the middle of, we're in the middle of them. And you don't get to stop here. You don't get to say, well, I'm not going to run again, so I think I'll go home. That's not how it works. It is very critical to the city that we keep going every day. And part of keeping going every day, part of what you need to do in this job, I've learned, is you need to make sure that the way we do these things has the long view in terms of the city's financial viability. There's plenty to do. That doesn't happen by itself. There's plenty to do to keep that happen. So there's lots to do and lots to continue here in the next 3 or 4 months, 3 months.
Okay.